Hey guys, welcome to the Python Scrapy Beginner series. In this intro, we'll just go over what you'll be learning in this short course. So to start off, we're just going to go quickly through how long the course takes, and then we're going to go through why we are using Python Scrapy, what we're going to learn a bit more in depth, just going through the different videos quickly, and then we'll talk about what you'll be able to do at the very end of this course. So the only things you need to get started will be obviously a computer. You'll download Python, and then we'll be downloading the Python Scrapy framework. It's very easy to get set up and running with those, and we'll show you how to do that in the videos as well. The series is just 5 videos, which are between 20 to 25 minutes long. And we also have, along with the videos, accompanying articles that you can go through in your own time. We have lots of code examples and code snippets, Git repos that you can download with the fully working code. And we also have tools which plug into Scrapy to help you with stuff like scheduling and deployment as well. Okay, so why are we doing this series on Python Scrapy? Well, we're doing that because Python Scrapy has been out now for well over 10 years, and it's a very fully-fledged framework with all the bells and whistles that you might need. You can use it from small-scale web scraping all the way up to large-scale, so it really scales well. It's got great community support out there. So many different people are using it, so lots of people are there to answer your questions and help you if you get stuck. There's also lots of different middlewares that are available out there and lots of different modules which you can easily plug in to your existing setup and use straight away. So in this series, we're going to go through 5 different topics, starting with creating your first basic Scrapy spider that will scrape a real life website. Then cleaning the data to make sure that we can handle different edge cases that come up, if we need to manipulate the data slightly before we save it, and lots of different things like that. Then we'll be looking at the different ways we can store data, either in a database, in an Excel file, in JSON format. We'll go through all the different cases of how you can store data. Then we'll look at everything to do with bypassing anti-bots that some websites have to prevent people from scraping. So we'll be looking at user agents and proxies and their role in bypassing these website anti-bots. And then for the final video, we'll be looking at how you can deploy your spider to a server, schedule the spider to run at specific times, and then monitor that the job is running correctly and that the data is being scraped correctly. So at the end of this series, you should be able to scrape all the data you need from the sites you want to scrape it from, store it in the format you want. You will know how to use the Scrapy framework to save the data in the exact way that you want and that you need for your project. And then we'll tie it all off in a professional way by looking how you can schedule and deploy the jobs to get that data when you need it exactly. So it's as simple as that, guys. If you think that any of that is interesting, please follow along the rest of the series. And if not, well, I hope we see you in one of our many other videos. Thanks, guys.